Hi, honey. You want to come and join us? We were talking about breast swell.
Well, congratulations, Marcy. You finally get to go bra shopping.
I don't have to tell you how much easier it is to lug around small things. Mind him of his dad. There's just one thing I want to know.
Oh, sure, Marcy. The part with the cups go in front. All right. Present company excluded, of course.
You better watch it, Al, if you want us to keep coming over.
Now, Marcy, don't take this as an insult. You, parakeet in a flannel shirt. But speaking as a friend, your body shows no signs of womanhood. Obvious to me, you're barren. And even if by some miracle you actually laid an egg and then hatched a child and tried to breastfeed it, the kid would starve to death because... Well, let's face it, Marcy, there can't be enough milk in there for a cup of coffee. So, having said that, with love, from one friend to another, I offer you the son you'll never have. Let me go get his clothes.
Oh. Al, I couldn't possibly take anything from you. Instead, let me give you something. 10 fingers of death. I hate you!
Let me help out here. Marcy, if you're worried about Jefferson succumbing to another woman, let me put your mind at ease. He will always be true to you, because after all, why go out for milk when you got 2 tiny empty pints at home?
And why go out for hot dogs when you've got a tiny little cocktail Frank at home? To the whole pig. Some people are just late bloomers. I myself was a late bloomer.
Well, whatever bloom must have got picked. Because I'm looking at some mighty arid country. She came here to purchase me as a sex toy.
This is impossible. Someone wants you for sex? What do you have, a pet orangutan who's lonely? And not picky?
Oh, I'm sorry. You two weren't properly introduced, I don't think. This is Marcy, our next door neighbor. As you can see, she probably used some of your vanishing cream on her breast. See, not a trace.
Him. I could see where you would think it was an orangutan. But I knew I recognized that bald spot when I spotted it from the freeway.
You know, Jefferson, good for you. You decided to take the Miller boy camping. Where's the little woman? Out shopping for some more of those little lacy t-shirts that so drive the men crazy?
Excuse me, but doesn't anybody know this is against the law?
So is dressing up a chicken and calling it your wife.
I am not a chicken. Why does he keep calling me a chicken?
Well, Marcy, congratulations. I didn't know you were expecting.
My oven is on the fritz, and I was hoping you could warm my giblets.
I thought that was your husband's unfortunate job.
No, it's my job to stuff the bird.
are so many things that I could point out right now. Your receding hairline, your depraved children.
Your chronically unsatisfied wife.
Thank you, Peggy. But I just think I'll keep it simple. You're a shoe salesman. Hi, Santa. Did one of your reindeer make a no-no? I'm sorry. That must be the ghost of foot fungus past.
Ho, ho, ho. You don't have to tell Santa what you want for Christmas. You want a pair of breasts. Just like a grown-up woman. But Santa says, be happy with what you've got. The body of a young boy. Here, little girl, have a candy cane.
You giving out replicas now, Al? Well, in that case...
Marcy? Well... I'm sorry, young fella. Marcy. Whoop. Sorry, thought you were my wife. excuse me, son. Hey, Marcy! Look, I've been looking all over for you. I found a store that carries that pump-up bra you wanted. Now you can pump them up to be any size you want, and you won't have to take Al's insults anymore. And the only one who will know they're not real is you. And me.
And me.
Look, Marcy, it's Al. Oh, God. I'm glad I didn't say anything that would embarrass me.
Well, hey, I won't say nothing. But if I were you, I'd build her arms at first, because from what I can see, she needs to do a lot of pumping.